Well, hello everyone, and welcome here to the Palais de Zombie Nobbling on Iris. And as you can see, I'm joined by one or two, just a few zombies here. How long have you got here? 176, roundabout. Why? Because, well, first of all, This is what 175 zombies sounds like. And the other reason is I added a potion stand to it. And I just added a few bits and pieces here, like there's a garden out here that's growing netherwort and melons. Most of the things you need, in fact, to make potions of healing. Now, I wonder what happens if you throw a splash potion of healing at 175 zombies. Well, I think it's going to be something like this. Ooh. I think I might have to put an epilepsy warning on this video. Wow. The balls in my face. Oh. Good lord. I wonder if this is going to end. Ever. We're on, what, we've got about four levels so far. This will be five. They're still, you hear them still falling in the background. Six. We're thinning out, we're starting to see the wall. Six and a half levels, four of which, nearly five of which were over 30, so that is a lot of experience. So, there you go. Fun and informative. And, quite surprisingly, I didn't pick up any rotten flesh while doing that. I'm thinking of rotten flesh. Let me show you something. I was walking through here the other day and I saw something out the corner of my eye, and I just refused to believe that I saw what I saw until I went and had another look. Whoa! Who put that hole there? Yes! I found a hole. No, look, I found a super zombie. I do like this. I don't think that one's going to fit in the Palais de Zombie Nobbling mind. But great design. I love this. It's I believe Wendy had a hand in this one, so well done, Wendy. Looking really good. So, there's crafting bench there. You might have seen that in the corner of your eye. I'm going to be doing a build over there fairly soon. And, well, I just leave crafting benches everywhere anyway. Wee-hee! Right. So, I'm here past the ranger station, which I need to do some work on. And out here, and it's all changed out here. There's this Too Many's treehouse with her diving board into that lake there. She died so many times making that, it was incredible. And there's going to be a build here by Andy Ray Sim. And up here, interesting little build, is this little cottage out here, out in the forest. And there's the garden going on here. Yeah, it's quite a nice little build. Yeah. So, there's a cellar down there. We won't go, but yet another one of those fridges that spits food at you. And why not? And up here, little chandelier, couple of cats, Tango and Hans Gruber. And this is a Miss Fujimoto build, and an excellent job I think she's done of it. Let's get back into town. Let's see what else is going on. I think we're going to have to come back here and clear out some of these trees, or at least repair them, because I don't like floaty trees. There seems to be quite a few of them around here. Perhaps we've had a little bit of a creeper incursion. I think we might want to extend the fences out here a bit. Perhaps. So, let's head back into town. Because there's a few bits and pieces going on in there. Alright, so... the first one here, as we're going past it, is just around the corner here, is Wendy's Christmas tree. And this is Wendy's house here. Which is... I don't like this build, and it's getting a bit overgrown, but she is Wend of the Jungle, so it's not surprising there's lots of vines on it. I thought she was in for a moment there. Oh, here it is. Here's her little Christmas tree, which I think is rather nice. Lots of different colours. Nice little design. They're very pretty. Good work there, Wendy. And I've been told that I need to keep my eye open when I need go into clucking good chicken, because apparently too many's played another prank on me. So let's see what she's done. Well, it sounds like it's still working. I thought the gullion was cold, so he got a scuff. Very nice. Oh, yes, I like that. I like that. That's good. And it's in clucking good chicken colours as well. How nice. Hey, well done, Too Many. I quite like that. And I've been redesigning this about a bit, as you can see. You can possibly see this road is one level lower. It's close to where I actually wanted it. And I've revisited this lake, and our beacons are now underwater. Which means I've got this nice little pool underneath the library. Still got to do some work on it, just to make it a bit prettier, but I think it's turning out alright so far. And finally, we can come in here and almost... still got a little bit more work to do on it, but I could almost get the view I wanted when I first made this. So, I'm getting quite happy with this, to be honest with you. Yes, I agree with you, Fluffy Bum. Right, what else? What else? There's another little build around here, but I can't think what a... Oh, wow. Hey! Where'd you come from? Hey! Yes, it seems like all the building is messed up with the lighting a little bit. We're going to have to do some work on that. Creeper, be warned. Hello. He was here yesterday. So, decided he wanted to stand in the rain. Yes. This is another little build we've been working on. And in fact, I think this is the one I'm going to finish this evening for you guys. So, let's just get rid of a bit of that. I've got a bit of space in my inventory. Let's grab some wool. Like that. In fact, let's clear a bit of this out. I don't need all this stuff. And let's get a bit more. Okay, and... well, as you can see, we are making what is going to turn out to be a snowman. And if you look carefully at the top, you can just about make out in the dark there his hat. And we've done the belly, and we started working on the head. And this evening, I think we're going to do a little bit of a condensed animation of me making the whole thing. Not all of it, because I'm sure you guys are getting pretty sick of just watching me put blocks on top of blocks. So I'll do some of it, and then we can get on, and if we're quick, get on to another build this evening. But... as you see, we've got the belly here, we've got the buttons, and the whole thing is basically made out of circles, or, well, ellipses is to give them the proper name. And so this one's already started here, so you can see the quarter circle, And then another quarter circle here. And but this one is not quite as done. So what we've been doing, and it has been a team effort, I've got to be honest with you, is we've been coming around here and putting down wool just to make the circles going up. This corner was not as complete because unfortunately somebody had to leave early, but still great effort from everybody. And it's one thing I really like about working on Iris is the whole community does come together and make these things, which makes me very, very happy that I started this world and I've invited people on. And it just gives us a chance to do stuff as a community, which I don't see on other... Well, I'm not going to say it never happens, but I just don't see it on other Minecraft servers. So that's what I'm going to be doing for the next... it's probably going to take me about half an hour to finish this off. Probably a bit longer, actually. And while I'm doing it, I just want to show you where we got the design from. There is a website called Plotz, P-L-O-T-Z. .co.uk, that's Z if you're American, and I think the hat is sheltering us from the rain. This, yay! And it gives you a number of different designs that are possible based upon concentric circles or ellipses like this one. I'm doing another piece of work along the same lines on the Minecraft server, not the Minecraft server, the Pixelmon server. Which you guys will be seeing over the next few weeks. And it gives you chances to make a snowman or a wizard's tower or an observatory, anything involving circles or ellipses. It's a great place. Basically, you go to the site plotz.co.uk, select the design you want, give it its dimensions, and it gives you a level-by-level example of how to build this. So I'm just going to carry on and finish this now. You've watched me do one quarter of it. There's no real need for you to see the rest of it. So what I will do is I'll give you perhaps a little bit of a condensed version of some of the building. And then I shall see you all at the end and we can get a final look of it without all this scaffolding around. So see you in a moment. Okay, right, you join us back here at an interesting bit. The plan says we need to start doing the nose. So this bit is the front, and the first layer of the nose is just six orange pieces of wool. Okay, I've just got to finish off the rest of this loop, and then we'll do the next level in just a second. we're up another level, and the next level of the beak is a little bit more complicated, but not that much. We go three out this side. Beak? Why don't you? I've got gullons on the brain at the moment, I have. It's not a beak, it's a carrot, it's a nose. One. So we get out three like this, and then we just repeat the same thing over the other side. So three like that. Two. Three like that. And I shall join you again when I do the next level for the, I think, the last bit of the carrot. The beak. Oh dear, the beak. See you in a second. Well, it does appear I was mistaken. There is, in fact, four layers to this beak. This carrot, and the next layer is exactly the same as the last. So we just build it out like that. On to the next layer. And so now we do the final bit of the nose, which is just purely and simply another six orange wool blocks along here to finish the job off. Okay, and we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 layers to go. We are very nearly done. So I'm going to cut out again now, and I'll see you at the top when I finish this and I've taken down all this scaffolding. See you in a second. Well, there you have it. Believe it or not, our little Christmas celebration is the largest structure in Iris. And I gotta be honest with you, I think it looks pretty damn good. So I want to thank everybody who helped, well, who did not helped, we worked together. So the people who helped me make this, who worked with me making this, were Wendy, Shizzy, Melody Flower, Andy Ray Sim, Miss Fujimoto, and Too Many Fandoms. So thank you very much, everybody, for all your help. It's been really marvelous doing this with you guys. And as is, I think I'm going to... 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just give everyone a little Christmas present. Merry Express. There you go. And let's just go and pop those into everybody's mailboxes. So they'll get them the next time they go and check their mail. And then I've got one tiny little thing left to do, and then I think I'm going to call it an episode. But thinking of Christmas, I will be doing a live stream on Christmas Day, as is becoming a tradition. And you are all welcome, of course, to come and join. It will be on Christmas Day, of course, from 9 p.m. British Summer Time. British Summer Time, Greenwich Mean Time. 9 p.m. GMT, which is 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time or 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And I will be playing a number of games. I haven't quite decided yet, but I'll be playing for, I should imagine, a good 4 to 5 hours at the very least. So if you are sick and tired of Christmas Day, there's only so much turkey one can eat. Or, you know, quite frankly, if you just want to take a break, you are more than welcome to come and join me and keep me company on that day. I won't put one in my mailbox. On beam.pro/SimonParsons. So yeah, there's a quick little Christmas present for everyone. I say a quick little Christmas present. It took me a day to get those wither skulls. It's so much fun camped out on a crossroads in the nether waiting for giant skeletons to attack you. Just wonderful stuff. But there's one final thing I want to do here, which is I want to set up a couple of beacons on our next big project area, which is out here. We are going to be making a whole new town, a sister town to the town of Iris. And you can see the Gullens have moved in already. It's going to be out here. We've spent the last, couple of months flattening this out and getting dirt and making the basic structure in place. Just we've taken down a forest and we've basically flattened an entire tree. So, 7, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You know what? I don't think I've brought enough blocks with me. So I'm going to put down a few here, and then I think I'm going to disappear for a second and come back with some. So let's get this done as much as we can. That's not much. Okay, I shall see you all in just a second. So we'll just chuck this up here. Yeah, I don't think I'll try to punch that through. Just put some stuff up here. And then if we put the beacons on top, 1, 2, 3, lovely illumination. So this one, we'll have haste, because we'll be doing building, we'll be have resistant. We'll have haste. Let's do that, and we'll have resistance. Let's do that. And we'll have strength. Let's do that. It's been so long since I set up beacons, I did that wrong, didn't I? But I do like that look, actually. So that's actually one too big now, but there we go. So if we look at, we now have haste, strength, and resistance. That'd be permanent, and I've got enough stuff to build another one over there, which I shall do so off camera. So there we go, guys. We have the biggest snowman in existence. Oh, I'm sure somebody will build a larger one now just to prove me wrong. And we have a building beacon out here, which is going to enable us to lay down stuff faster. It's really good. Look at that pickaxe go. And I've just given everyone a quick Christmas present as well. So, guys, until the next time, Merry Christmas to you too. A Happy New Year. Whatever festival, whatever thing that you worship, I wish you happiness and fun doing so. And I shall see you all very, very soon. So until then, thank you and good night.